Workers have been forced to kill hundreds of thousands of chickens after an outbreak of bird flu sent two farms in Victoria into quarantine. This week, the Victorian government has also confirmed the first human case of the virus has been detected in Australia. Now, joining me live for more on this is Dr. Emma Grant, who's an immunologist from La Trobe University. Dr. Grant, thanks very much for joining us. What exactly is bird flu and what's the difference between the strains that have been detected in Victoria this week?
So thank you for having me. And the question on everyone's lips is obviously, what is bird flu? So we often hear about seasonal influenza viruses that circulate in humans, but bird flus are influenza viruses that particularly circulate throughout animals and in particular wild birds and poultry. And so when we're thinking about influenza viruses, we might hear these different terms, so H5s, H7s, and these are related to the different proteins. And this is how we characterize the different viruses. So what's happening in Victoria this week, we've heard of the H7N3 viruses in the farms and the H5N1 virus that was identified in the child returning from overseas in March. And because these have different H and N proteins, we do know that they are different virus strains and are unrelated.
How concerning is it that bird flu is now being detected at two farms, and how likely is it to spread to other farms?
So avian flu can actually spread really rapidly between animals. And as we've just heard, they're taking the quarantine very seriously to minimise any further risks. And the two farms that have had identified cases are thought to be or reported to be linked. Animals can get them from, can get influenza infections from being in contact with infected animals, drinking from water sources contaminated with fecal matter, and coming into contact with contaminated surfaces. So to minimise the spread, farmers and the departments are working thoroughly to make sure that the spread is minimised.
And so how much of a problem is this for the agriculture industry?
Yeah, it's obviously concerning when we hear about these things, but we have had instances of bird flu in Australia in the past. However, thanks to the quick work of vigilant farmers and the department authorities, these have been quickly contained, and the same it should be expected to happen with this H7N3 strain.
What are the chances of humans becoming infected with bird flu?
Yeah, so thankfully, animal-to-human transmission is actually quite rare, and this is because the viruses that circulate in the avian space, I actually find it really hard to bind to human cells. And we're finding that only in specific circumstances, such as individuals being in close proximity to infected animals for prolonged periods of time, do we see these animal-to-human transmission occurring.
Sure, some people are worried when they hear this is happening at an egg farm. Is it safe for people to consume eggs and chicken at the moment?
Yes, it is indeed very safe. So there's no evidence at all that avian influenza can be contracted through eating properly cooked chicken meat or eggs at all.